So with the ever-changing landscape of the MCU, we've heard that various actors who have been here from the beginning are probably going to be leaving. I think the most famous one everybody always focuses on is Chris Evans, obviously leaving Captain America, because he seems to want to do more stuff in Hollywood, like direct his own things and, you know, kind of expand out there. But apparently that might be changing. So really, getting rid of Captain America would probably be the most insane thing you could do in the MCU. I mean, you know, it's Captain America. It's just that alone right there, the leader of the Avengers, that's kind of a big deal. And for a while, even with Chris Evans saying, you know, his goodbye and everything, they've kind of tried to walk that back. And recently, the Russo brothers, Joe and Anthony Russo, who directed Winter Soldier to start, but then of course went on, did Avengers Infinity War, are doing Avengers 4, and are looking to do more stuff, talked specifically about Chris Evans, and they said that they're not sure anymore if he's going to be leaving. So this is kind of an opposition of what he said with his goodbye, but at the same time, this could just be a, you know, kind of way of looking into it to maybe saying, look, Captain America isn't going to die, because let's be real, if you're going to do the so long teased down the road, it's coming in forever Secret Wars movie, it seems like a no-brainer that at some point you're probably going to want Captain America. And if you kind of keep him alive and maybe he's just not active, then that would kind of make sense to me. You could bring him back somewhere down the road in 10 years and have him pick up the mantle. And at that point, you're probably going to be getting $3 billion from an Avengers movie, especially if it's Secret Wars uniting everything you've ever done. So it makes a lot of sense. And at this point, we already know they're like using actors and scanning them. So in 20 years, if an actor comes back for some role, they got them set, right? So they don't have to do new de-aging technology. They got them for whatever time period they wanted them, and Disney now works on that technology actively. So I think realistically what they're telling people here is expect these actors to leave because they want to get out there, and we're not going to be able to pay every actor $25 million a movie, because when we put five of them into a movie, there goes the entire budget, right? So they can't afford that. But clearly, I think they want to keep a lot of these characters active as sort of a contingency. So I would say maybe one or two might die, but someone's got to stay alive, because once they all go away, you're kind of breaking this point in the MCU where a lot of people go, well, the characters I liked, they're dead, so I don't know, I might not like these new ones. You see that a lot with Ant-Man, you see that somewhat with Guardians, and we don't know how people are going to react to Captain Marvel yet, so they have to be very careful with how they're going to play out with this. So I could see what they're saying here and kind of how they're coming at it.